Going live in 3, 2, 1. Welcome back, ladies and gents. I'm your host, Luisa Conscious. It's great to have you here, guys. I've been doing this job for a long time, and let me tell you, you're in for a fucking treat. Her mind is a mess. Camera 5, can we make sure that she can't see as we're trying to keep it undercover here? Okay. Much too late, a Tuesday night, she's on a date. A nice little quaint spot she told him she'd been to multiple times before. Liar. In reality, she was responsible for booking a place, but no surprise, she forgot because she was too busy doing what again? Anyway, a quick Google search promised her 3-star rated spare ribs for him, a salad for her, and cheap vodka soda, say no more. The waiter promised a nice little spot in a corner far away, a bird's eye view over their fellow diner so that if silence would ensue 20 minutes into the date, she could talk about the hairdo of the guy to their right and the peculiar way the lady to their left would pick her nose in between bites of tortellini. She seems to be getting a bit drunk, too drunk I believe. She's really doubting that shit now, and while she's switching between dew eyes and siren eyes, because someone on the internet told her to, her mind wanders off. Now it's time for me to shine, ladies and gents. I send electrical waves through her brain, whisper in her ear that she kinda sucks, and that she should probably check if there isn't a booger hanging out of her nose, or worse, a piece of a legume stuck between her teeth. I've really grabbed her attention now, she's mine for the night. What a shame, he was quite a nice guy. Fast forward Wednesday morning, god, she's hungover, it's gonna be a shit day and she doesn't even know it yet. Eyes balls sucked into Ziploc bags of skin and mascara. Oh, but wait, there she is, good morning, beautiful! Mornings are the hardest for me. She's usually full of hope at this time. She hasn't checked out her face in the mirror yet, but sooner or later she's gonna have a real shocker and I become the captain of the ship. I make her do that gua sha thing and overthink her texts. Over the years, she's found ways to dial me down, you know, keep me quiet. They will try. But on days like these, I'm like a kid in a fucking candy store with a microphone and a party horn that I give a good blow when she least expects it. Great for making her panic a bit, honestly.
Good morning! I got a new keyboard, guys. I'm gonna show you that later because it's so cool. And I also have this laptop stand, so like I'm sitting like this. And I never get back pain anymore because if you're like that, you get terrible pain and hernias in your back. Not for me. I am gonna do a quick sweep of the room so it's clean and nice and organizado when I come back and I don't get a panic attack because there's shit lying everywhere. Ew! Oh, what the fuck? There's like a... Oh, I'll show you. Someone stood on a banana and now it's completely... Oh, I hate that when it happens. Oh, that actually... Just gonna put it outside for a sec. And now there's like banana feces everywhere, you know? Oh, also on my pants. Okay, whatever. I have quite a lot of things to do today. I have a lot of adrenaline in my body. I wake up and I was immediately like, let's fucking go, you know? Sometimes I have that when I wake up. I'm so excited to do this day. So I'm really excited to do it for today to do... For today, today. Okay. It's too hard.
Don't worry, we'll have some fun later. Around 12 o'clock, I usually start infiltrating her conscious. I like to keep my job simple, though. I have this tape recording that I just put on repeat about the way she smells and exam stress. If I'm feeling up to it, though, I can add in some visuals and some temperature changes as well. Make her sweat a bit and pick her nails. It's great.
I dreamed that love was a crime. I was alone. They found me guilty.
You know, sometimes I do feel bad for her. I tell her nasty things about the way she looks, the way the back of her hair is weird and her face is too round and her arms too flabby. But I keep her in check, you know? Keep her looking real good. Keep her caring about the things that really matter, like plucking her eyebrows and making sure that she isn't too much herself around others, because imagine what people around her would fucking think, right? And I'm protecting her, really. But as of recently, I've been having a hard time, guys. She's managed to hide my microphone and the arsenal of sound effects that used to rile her up real good not so long ago. I don't know what's happening, really. I mean, when I signed up for this job, I thought I was in for a treat. Insecure female who counts calories. Can't get much easier than that, right? I've heard from colleagues that recently there's this fucking plague going around called happiness. It's honestly dire. A lot of us are out of jobs now, trying to get by day. I hope that the winter comes soon or that she gets her heart broken or something, because at this rate, I don't know how long until I'm made redundant. Aha, this is my favorite time. She's about to surround herself with people and I'm gonna make sure she thinks that they all hate her. Selfish, really, but that's my job. During nights like these, I love to hover above her, have a beer with one of my colleagues in the mind of another 20-something-year-old. Honestly, sometimes I wish I could tell her that they recruit us in masses, you know? We're all trained with the one objective of making you all overthink and overthink everything. I made sure she was real bloated when she got here, but she doesn't seem to fucking care. Look at her now.
Before I go to bed, I just wanted to thank everyone who comment on my videos, because I genuinely think that like the reactions I receive on my videos are like so sweet, and I feel like I'm very, very lucky, even though I have a very small audience, to have like such a wholesome, like really nice amount of people like commenting on my videos, and the comments are always so thoughtful, or yeah, they I'm not gonna lie, I know it sounds a little bit cringe, but like they really fill me with joy. Yeah.
They're super nice and they make me so happy. Like really, like, oh damn, like people actually like this stuff, you know? Like it's a really cool thing thought to have, like just putting stuff out on the internet and then people actually like taking the time out of their day to react to it and leave like really nice comments as well. I think it's super cool when...
Yeah. Thanks a lot, guys. It makes me so happy.
Hey, get fucking back here! Hey, you need to shave your armpits. You need to get rid of that unibrow hair. Hey, you need to shave your armpits. You need to get rid of that. You need to wax your lip. You need to go on a diet. You need to paint your nails. You need to buy new clothes. You need to shave your armpits. You need to get rid of that unibrow. Stop it. Find that t-shirt. You lost dye your hair. You need to study for your exams. You need to stop doing this. You need to stop being yourself. You need to be more like me. Fuck. Thank you.